Hello and welcome to this session on how to create a jar file. Today we are going to learn how do we create a runnable jar from our Eclipse project, and then we will see how can we run our Selenium test through this jar file from the command line. We will also look at some useful tips. Let us begin. The very first step is we have to create a runnable jar. Let us go to our Eclipse project. And this is the project that we have been creating in our earlier sessions. And in our last session, we created a config file. And now we are passing the browser value from the config file. We are no longer going inside the code and changing the browser every time. Today we are going to go a step ahead and we will learn how can we run our test from outside Eclipse through the jar file. So for that, go to your project, do a right click, select export, and in this window you can start typing jar. You will get the option of runnable jar file. Select and click next. In this window you have to select the launch configuration. So you have to select your project and the class which has the main method. In our case it is first Selenium test, and then you can give any export destination wherever you want to save your jar file. So you can save it anywhere. However, it will be very handy if you save it within the project destination. So I have given my project destination here and I have given the name as selenium-test.jar file. You can keep the other options by default and click on finish. You will get some warnings, which is okay, and then you will have your jar file created. So to save time, I have already created this jar file and it is here. Also, you can go physically to the location of your project and you can see the jar file is created here. So this is how you create a runnable jar file. Step number two is now you have to run your Selenium test through the jar file from the command line. So let me go to command line, and I'm on Mac, so I'm going on to terminal. In case you are on Windows, you can go to your command line. The steps will be the same. And now I have to go to the location of this jar file. So I will just copy this location and I will go to this location, CD and the location. And now I have to say java space hyphen jar and the name of the jar file. So selenium-test.jar, and I will just hit enter and run it. So you see it has started running the Chrome browser and started running our test, and it is finished. Now let us do a thing. Let us go to our config file physically. I am not going to Eclipse, I am doing everything outside Eclipse. This is the config file. Let us open this and let me just change the browser from Chrome to Firefox. So I have changed it to Firefox and save it, close it. Okay, and now let me run it again. So again I am saying java space hyphen jar and the jar name. So see, it is Firefox now, and you can see the Firefox browser is coming up, and now it is running our test on a Firefox browser. So on the Firefox browser it is running our test, and now it is completed. So you can see after creating this jar file you can run your test case from outside Eclipse. You do not have to go inside Eclipse for running your test every time. So this is how we run our Selenium test through a jar file from the command line. Let us look at some useful tips. So in case you are beginner to jar file, jar is an acronym for Java archive, and basically it is a zipped format of all the dot class files of your project. And in case you want to know a little more details and basics of jar file, you should watch this Java 7 tutorial. You can go to my channel and go to the Java playlist. Let me go to the playlist section. In the playlist, go to the Java playlist, and here you will find this session, 7th one, which is on jar file, and it is a 10 minutes very interesting session. You will get to know a lot about jar files here, so please watch this. The second thing is I want to tell you about a Java decompiler, and if you go to the browser and type Java decompiler, you will get this website. Click here, and here is the Java decompiler. You can download it from here, and it basically unzips your jar file. So as I said, that jar file is a zipped format of the dot class files, and in case you want to get your Java files back from the dot class files from the jar file, you can use this. And actually this is again explained in the same session, the Java 7 session, so please watch that. Let us do a very quick recap. Today we learned how do we create a runnable jar file, and then we used the jar file to run our Selenium test from the command line from outside Eclipse. I hope this session was very useful for you. In case you have any questions or any doubts, please do write them down in the comments section. I will try to answer them as soon as I can. I will meet you in the next session. Thanks for watching.